Live stream. Today is the Hartford Whalers taking on the hometown Michigan Hornets. The Hornets coming off of a nail-biting win just a few moments ago against the Hollywood Hattricks. That one ending in slightly controversial fashion, but nonetheless, we took a look at it and determined that it was indeed a good goal for the Michigan Hornets. So we get back on our way. Blackus getting it past Jam. Hornets recover. Boilerator on it. He'll send it in. Blackus lets one off. Go. Led again by Jam. Trying to get around Blackus. Jam again. Black has got one through. Moya's gonna bring it back to the near side. Boilerator and Black is the line that's been stellar for these Hartford Whalers. Trying to get something done here. Black is centering. Jams in the way. Black is again. Back across. He'll get it back in and flipped up and out of play is the puck by Moya. So we got a stoppage. 4:07 to go. Face off win for Blackus. Steering it. Blackus with it. Fighting Jam over it. And Jam will send it back out. Boilerator again. Lost it. And back up the way. Exena. The puck's in the bench for the broadcast. Full roster tonight, I believe, for the Hartford Whalers. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Looks like it, actually. Or they might be missing one person. Mighty Hen's not on their roster.
True. Six players at the rink for the Hartford Whalers. Gonna take a quick look at the BHL contracts.
And they have seven.
Yeah, they have seven players. Nick 12 is the absent man for Hartford tonight. Absent for the Michigan Hornets is Squid. Everybody else is present. Lanchier lost it to Oilerator, and here come the Whalers. Recovered by Lanchier, and he's got a break. But stepping in is Oilerator, and now he'll hold it behind the net. He slaps a pass to W5, but that's turnover, and Lanchier takes the lead. Terrible line change for the Hartford Whalers. Flashy.
Yeah, there. As soon as he changed, it was just an easy goal there.
Well, actually, I'm not even sure that they necessarily went for a change, per se, but, no, yeah, they did. Oilerator was getting off for Blackus and trying to leave W5 on the ice, but nonetheless, Lanchier got control of the puck and had too much time and space, and the Whalers couldn't keep it away. Exenot. And he'll give it over to W5. Steered to the near side and turned around by Blackus. Exenot again. Played to the far side by Blackus and out of play. taking another look at it, they're never... Oilerator again with the puck. Oh, yeah. And yes, there was indeed a line change there, but they just didn't get their second player on the ice in time.
Yeah.
Normally, when you go off for a change, your second player ends up on the ice before the first gets off, which is legal in real hockey, and it's legal here as well, but they didn't play it that way, and so they had one player defending, and that's how the Hornets were able to get that much time and space to get the shot off. Oilerator again. Can't quite hold the blue line. Tagging back up as Blackus. Shot there off the post! Oilerator again. Cleared out. Sent back in. Now waiting patiently is Exonaut. And he'll slide one back into the neutral zone. Almost threaded the needle. But Lynchier is going to have to finish that job. Blackus waiting. Flaps one past Lynchier. Sent back up ice. Lynchier again. And as he tags up, he's going to get a penalty here for an interference call. An interference penalty. So the Whalers get a power play. Face-off win for W5. Shot got off. But a routine save there for Dylan. And now a breakaway the other way. And Exonaut scores one shorthanded. Hashi.
Yes.
Break that one down for us.
Well, that's unfortunate for the Whalers, giving up a short-handed goal. Really, I don't know. What do you think?
Well, for one, the penalty on Lynchier was completely justified. I don't know what he's complaining about. And second, the Whalers have got to play better defense on the power play. I mean, yes, you do have a man advantage, but you only have it for 30 seconds anyway, and if you do end up turning it over, if you don't have a guy back, you're going to let up an easy chance.
Yeah. Yeah, you said it pretty good there. Just trying to do the box scores while I'm talking here.
First period finally comes to a close, and the Hornets, as is customary this season, are up by 2. Now, Flashy, one of the things that's kind of been a talking point this season has been those slap shots. Do you have any points on those?
I think slap shots are great. They allow for different like levels of how far the puck travels.
Shot scores! Blackus cuts the lead in half.
Yeah, that's just what the Whalers needed there. Get some momentum on their side.
And a quick goal, 8 seconds in. Could this be the start of a comeback for Hartford?
So, on that first goal, did Jam score an XO assist? Do you remember?
Let me look back.
When do you get a chance? You don't have to do it now.
Blackus. Face off against Jam. Hexenaut with it. And it's flipped out of play. We get a stop. .442 to go. First goal was scored by Lynchier from Hexenaut. Comrade. Brought it, or brings it back across. Checked there late by Jam, no call from the ref. Flashy Gaming is our official for tonight's activities. As Jam speeds it through. Blackus. Lizard off the board, stolen by Jam, but back on his stick and cleared. Blackus has it again. Got it past Hexenaut, but Hexenaut's gonna play the methodical game. Finds Jam, and Jam's got it in. Shot there! Save there for Alfresco!
W5K.
What was that?
Alfresco is not on ice.
Ah. W5K now in net. And ref's gonna blow that one dead. Face off. Now Lynchier. Shot and he scores! Second of this game! And this one comes unassisted at 3:26. But with 3:26 to go, that would be 1:54 into this period.
So did Lynch score the first goal?
Lynch scores the first goal from Hexenaut.
Alright.
And the second goal comes from Hexenaut unassisted, and the third goal is from Lynch here unassisted. And I believe Blackus was unassisted on his goal. Yes, he was. Lynch here. Can't get a shot on net there, as the Whalers headman the rush. Back the other way, Lynchier gets it back. And now he's gonna dangle around Comrade. Slick hands there, but Comrade finally is able to get a stick on it and take it away. On it again is Lynchier as he brings it across the blue line. Centered, but Moya wasn't there, and so Lynchier's gonna have to take the shot on his own centering pass. Back the other way. Lynch here again. Let's one go on net. And back through center. Moya getting a stick on it. Comrades there as well. Oilerator can't get past Lynch here. And Hornets continue to work here. Oilerator by himself in the offensive zone now as they change. And Oilerator's gonna try and thread it to Blackus, but Blackus wasn't there to receive it. Blackus turns it back around, and he's got the zone. Oilerator. Blackus. Powering his way towards the net. Still lost it, and Lynchier's gonna hop off on a chain. Blackus wound up and plants one into Jam. And a second in Amoya. And now it's going to find its way out of play. A minute 38 to go, second period. And the Whalers trail by two. That one's tossed back out. Face off win for Jam. Got one on net, but a good save there. And back the other way, W5. Blackus forces it to the boards. Offensive zone. W5 bounces it off the post, trying to feed Blackett. Now back the other way. Here comes Blackett. Out to play it. Dangerously was Dylan. And that's an easy pick for Blackett. And the lead's back to only one. Can the Oilers continue their comeback? Or will the Hornets gain back the 2-goal lead? We'll find out. 1:06 to go in the period. Jam. Up ice. Now Oiler in. He will find his teammate W5. W5 crossed the blue line but turned it over. An Oiler Raider is going to have to bail his team out on that one. Jam. Waits. Works his way around Oiler Raider and the Oilers get it back. Neutral zone again. Jam turning. Trying to dangle around W5 but he can't dangle around Oiler Raider. So the Whalers get it back. Well, Whalers lost it. And now Jam's gonna fly one close, but not in. And now 2-on-1 the other way. And W5 made a great mistake to send it way up the ice. But now he's gonna get a shot off there. A couple of good chances against Dylan. But the Oilers probably could. Or the Oiler Raiders, the Whalers probably could have had a better opportunity if they hadn't sent the puck so far ahead and lost possession there. That last goal scored by Blackus came unassisted at 4:54, or 3:54 rather. Final stanza underway, and then the Hornets have the puck. Lynch here. Lost it. Bounce back in center ice. Exonaut's gonna wait. And he'll feed Lynch here. Or not. Take it back across. Lynch here's got the zone again. Protecting it was Lynch here. As he tried to drive it around. Oiler Raider feeds Blackus. And the Whalers come through. Blackus has the zone, but he lost the puck, and so the Hornets get it back out. Kept in at the blue line there for Lynch here. Right in the corner. And it comes back down. Sent in. Exonaut. Lost it again. Blackus. He'll center. Exonaut back up for Lynch here. Brought to the near side. And the Hornets denied entry. However, the puck's still in. Now it's out. And here comes Blackus through the neutral zone. Blackus for the hat trick. Couldn't get a shot there. And it's cleared out by the Hornets. Oiler Raiders got it back in. Lost it. And he'll come all the way back. And the Oilers don't even make an attempt to play it. As they go for a change there. W5. And he makes a... He's continuing to clap it up the ice. Now he does have it in the zone. And a full change made for the Oilers. Comrade. Coming to the far side. Exonaut trying to chip it out. That one came close. Centered and Comrade. Didn't get a shot off. W5. Lost it. And now break jam. Shot saved there by Alfresco. The rebound. Scramble from the Whalers. And still within his jam. And he gets another couple of shots. Still with it. Jam got it back in. And another save for Alfresco. Jam again. Shot it off the post. And the Hornets come alive late in this period. 2:15 to go. W5 and Blackus on the ice for the Whalers. And a face-off win for them. Here comes Blackus. Shot. Got through. Score! And it's tied by a hat trick from Blackus.
Dang. That is game-changing.
All three of Blackus's goals tonight unassisted. He's been absolutely perfect as far as goal scoring is concerned, coming at all the right times. And he's clawed the Whalers all the way back into this one. Blackus doing what he does best, carrying the Whalers on his back. And that's got to be a tough burden considering how heavy Whales are. Linkshear. Trying to get it to Exonaut, but Blackus is there. Whalers turning. Cutting back. And now Oilerator on it. Lost it. And Exonaut's got the zone. Brings it off the boards. Let's one go. And it's in there for Alfresco. Exonaut gets around Blackus. But the Whalers are going to play behind the net and hold. And Linkshear, big check there on Oilerator. To get the puck back. Great forechecking for the Hornets. The Whalers, I think, are trying to get it to overtime, which would at least score them 1 point. Linkshear has the offensive zone. These two teams have both clinched playoff spots already this season, I believe. Or no, the Hat Tricks and the Hornets have clinched playoff spots. The Whalers and the Ice Caps on the outside looking in, if I'm not mistaken. Linkshear. Pressure here from the Whalers defense as they're playing both men on him. And Linkshear's been fighting them off for a couple of seconds now. Still with it is Linkshear, despite getting bullied in the corner. And he's gonna bully his bulliers. Still in the offensive zone. Whalers are wasting time here. And they are going to be successful in at least finding overtime. Third comes to an end. And we'll start the extra hockey. Flashy, how's the playoff standings looking?
Playoff standings?
Yes.
Well, like you said, the Hollywood Hat Tricks and Michigan Hornets have clinched. Hat Tricks have clinched at least third place, and I think so have the Michigan Hornets. But really what it comes down to is how the Flight performs tomorrow. If the Whalers and Ice Caps want to clinch. I think if the Flight loses both games tomorrow, then they clinch and the Flight are out of playoff contention.
It would not surprise me if the San Francisco Flight do not make the playoffs in their first season back, simply because they have not been able to get players to, big thing is players have been unresponsive specifically in the name of Deserted, who was completely absent for the entirety of last weekend and the second game the weekend before that, as we get started in this overtime period. But San Francisco is definitely going to need to get something going for them if they want to even have a shot at a title. Exonaut lost it to Blackus, and the Whalers coming back up. W5 lets one go, but it's denied by Exonaut. Still with it. Pushing it up is W5. And he's got it still. Sent to the corner. And W5's gonna bully both players off him. And the Hornets wanted a penalty. Shot got through! Score! It's over! The Hartford Whalers win it off of the Blackus' stick in overtime. And the Hornets wanted a penalty bad, but he was on the puck. And Jam wants a challenge. They are going to challenge. Except that they can't challenge a penalty. Referee gonna ask them what the challenge is. They want to challenge interference. They want to challenge interference, but you cannot challenge a penalty. And taking a look back at it, I'm going to take a look at this real quick. So I will deafen, or mute at least. Taking a look back at the penalty that the Hornets want. Right here, they want a penalty on W5. However, it's very obvious that both of these hits are players attempting. They're both attempting to take the puck from W5. W5 very clearly has possession of the puck. Both players are on said puck, and so both of those hits are legal. I gotta go to the replay. Here is the replay. You can clearly see W5 is on the puck, and so is Exonaut, so is Jam. So both of those hits are legal, and the ref saw both of them. Puck ends up going in off of, well, I don't even know how that puck curves. That is a strange looking goal. I think Black has got a piece of it, and that's what directed it on net. And then everybody scrambles, and Black has finds it, and this game is over. So there's nothing that they can do. Well, thank you for tuning into this one. I've been DNP alongside. Well, actually, never mind. Forgot. We gotta go for 3 stars. I was about to sign off, but we've got 3 stars of the game coming up. And I believe they are going to be chosen by Flashy. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for your 3 stars of tonight's game. The 3rd star of tonight's game. from your Michigan Hornets is excellent. Number 7, Exonaut, second star of tonight's game. With 2 goals tonight, is number 17, Lynchier. And now for the number 1 star of tonight's game, with a hat trick and the game-winning goal, from the visiting Hartford Whalers, number 2, Blackus Nitus. Thank you so much for tuning in to the BSN. And until the next one tomorrow, I've been DNP. Alongside me has been our official for tonight, Flashy McClashy, or Flashy Gaming. And I will see you later. Take care, everybody.